more people are eating fake meat, and big corporations want to make money off of it. But is fake meat better for you or better for the planet? Welcome to America Uncovered, I'm Chris Chappell. Eating meatless meat is growing more and more popular. And by meatless meat, I mean processed food that's supposed to look and taste like meat, but that's made of plants. Supposed to being the key phrase. They should rename tofurkey to wet socks flavored gelatin slices. More people are eating fake meat, and that's a trend that's expected to keep rising for the foreseeable future. And fake meat is starting to look and feel more like real meat these days. Have you tried the Impossible Burger? It even bleeds like meat. I didn't know that plants bleed. That makes playing They Love Me, They Love Me Not pretty metal. The value of the plants-based foods market almost doubled between 2017 and 2020. All this demand means there's a chance to make a lot of money. Veggie alternatives to meat have been around forever, but only recently did they come close to looking and tasting like meat. Arguably. I mentioned the Impossible Burger before. Impossible Foods is one of the brands that's leading this food revolution. The other is Beyond Meat. They've both partnered with food chains around the US. Burger King now has an Impossible Whopper.
We fed beef lovers a Whopper with no beef.
You can't imitate beef, it just tastes better.
Turns out these beef lovers love plants too.
That's an Impossible Whopper?
I'm a damn fool.
Impossible Whopper with a patty made from plants, only at Burger King.
So it tastes as good as a Whopper. That PR isn't nearly as good as they think it is. A charcoal brick covered in mayonnaise tastes as good as a Whopper. And last year, Burger King introduced vegan nuggets to US locations as well. Burger King says its goal is for its menu to be 50% meat-free by 2030. Meanwhile, McDonald's has been trying out a McPlant sandwich. Hopefully this will go better than the last time they tried a meat alternative, Soylent Purple. Soylent Purple is grimaces! It's grimaces! And Kentucky Fried Chicken introduced the plant-based Beyond Fried Chicken. White Castle now has an Impossible Slider. Qdoba has an Impossible Meat option for tacos and bowls. Red Robin, Bear Burger, and the Cheesecake Factory all offer the Impossible Burger. Carl's Jr., TGI Fridays, Subway, Dunkin' Donuts, and Denny's all offer various Beyond Meat options. And Taco Bell's meat is also meatless, although that's always been the case. Pretty sure this is just ground up shoe leather and chili powder. But despite all these fast food chains using plant-based meat, Beyond Meat and Impossible Foods aren't really making a profit. That's not a problem for them now since they're getting billions in funding. But some analysts think this is going to be an issue for these companies in the future. Plant-based meat companies are betting that more people will switch over. But is fake meat better for you and the environment? I'll have more on that after the break. Welcome back. So what's driving the interest in plant-based meat? Well, a major reason is health. People think eating plant-based meat is healthier for them. But is it? There are several differences between fake meat and real meat. Real meat is actual meat, while fake meat will act friendly to your face, then talk trash about you behind your back. Plant-based meat is usually highly processed and can have an ingredient list that's a mile long. Although real meat can also be pretty processed and have unhealthy additives like sodium nitrate and sodium phosphate. For people concerned about cholesterol, fake meat has almost no cholesterol. But if you're avoiding meat for your heart, just know that fake meat often has more sodium. Depending on the brand, plant-based meats might also have lower levels of some nutrients, such as zinc, vitamin B12, and iron. A Duke University researcher looking at the differences said, consumers should know real meat and alternative meat products are not nutritionally interchangeable, even if the numbers on the nutritional labels look the same. Okay, but at least fake meat has fewer calories than real meat, right? It depends. Every fake meat is different, so you really have to compare each one individually. But when you compare the Whopper with the Impossible Whopper, they're actually pretty similar. They both have between 600 and 700 calories. So fake meat isn't necessarily healthier than real meat. As for the environment, we did a whole episode about meat's impact on the environment. Check it out, the link is below. But what if we were to grow meat in a lab? I'll have more on that after the break. Welcome back. Many people say we need to save the planet by eating less meat. Some want plant-based meat. Others see the future in cultured meat. And I don't mean meat made from cows that breed the New Yorker. I mean meat that you grow in a lab. The world's first lab-grown hamburger was eaten in London in 2013. The burger was grown from stem cells from a dead cow. In case you're wondering why you haven't seen it in stores yet, it can't legally be sold in the US. The only place it's currently legal is in Singapore. But that could change. And the C in KFC might soon stand for clones. Proponents of lab-grown meat say it could be healthier. It doesn't require antibiotics. You could add more vitamins and minerals to it while cutting saturated fat. And it might taste just as good as normal meat.
We analyzed the different components that make those beautiful cuts and try to figure out which are the key components that we need to mimic in order to achieve those beautiful cuts of meat.
Our technology can create whole muscle cuts just as a cow can produce that in a much more efficient way with a lower cost. And of course, it's much better for the environment.
After COVID, I think we all deserve to have delicious, healthy, environmentally friendly steaks leak from a lab and spread around the globe. Now, you might think that lab-grown meat would be better for the environment. It uses hardly any land, there's no manure or cow farts, and you don't have to feed or water it. Well, except with cell cultures. According to one study in 2011, lab-grown meat had much lower greenhouse gas emissions, as well as using much less energy, land, and water. The Good Food Institute and the European animal rights group GAIA found similar results. But more recent studies suggest that lab-grown meat could create more problems than it solves. According to a 2019 study, the long-term temperature impact of cultured meat production is dramatically worse than any cattle system. That's because there are a lot more than just cow farts you have to factor in. For one, creating and maintaining the infrastructure to create lab-grown meat takes a lot of energy and resources. And because methane from cattle doesn't last as long as the CO2 emitted from labs, it could be worse for climate change. According to a senior researcher at the Oxford Martin School, cellular-based meat alternatives release 5 times the emissions as chicken, putting their emissions just under beef. Now, maybe that could change if we use greener forms of energy. New advances in technology are already making lab-grown meat more affordable. Back in 2013, it cost around $325,000 to engineer a 5-ounce burger. That's more expensive than eating a burger made of solid gold. Not that you would want that. But now in 2022, an entire lab-grown chicken breast can be produced for as little as $1.70 a pop. And they're more ethical than alternatives like Soylent Purple. The biggest hurdle to making lab-grown meat mainstream could be getting people comfortable with the idea of eating something from a petri dish. After all, we have no idea what the long-term health effects could be. But considering people eat Twinkies and Cool Whip, well, how much worse could it be? So what do you think? Would you eat lab-grown meat? Let us know in the comments below. If you like this show, please know we could not do it without direct support from viewers like you. Visit patreon.com/AmericaUncovered and contribute $1 or more per episode to help us keep the show going. Once again, I'm Chris Chappell. Thanks for watching America Uncovered.